Aruna to serve. The two actually met twice in the past, with Xi Xin coming up as winner on both occasions. They first met in the year of 2015 in Poland, and specifically at Polish Open. Xi Xin won by 4-0, and the second time was last year when Xi Xin took on this gentleman right here from Africa at the ITTF World Tour Korea Open. In the round of 16, like this situation, Xi Xin took care of business 4-1. So this is their third official encounter. As a matter of both players enjoy being a little bit far away from the table. Chen Qi, a former Olympic champion in men's doubles. Oh, good return from Xi Xin there. Cross court, quick reaction and response. One might be surprised that as a penholder style player here, penholding style, I should say, and Xi Xin perhaps, you know, would love to stay as close as possible to the table according to the tradition. However, he's very European in that sense by being away from the table, launching his backhand with topspin by using the reverse side. And there's also one player like that from Hong Kong, China, namely Huang Chunting, who plays like that. Obviously, he's not here for this tournament. Close to party shot from Aruna. Yep. Speaking of Hong Kong, China, Huang Chunting also is here practicing because he's not attending this tournament. He will go to Macau later for the WTT event. That will be the inaugural WTT event to be held in Macau. So he is very excited and look forward. When I talked to him, he said that he is so much looking forward to that occasion as well to again showcase his style. He didn't do too well at the World Cup. He didn't really get to the second round. Well, as a matter of fact, he did, but I'm just saying he didn't really go further from round of 16 to the quarterfinals and so forth. So he would like to really make his presence felt later on the occasion of WTT. Great finish from Xi Xin right there with his top spin serve. Followed by his powerful forehand. Just simply too powerful. Beautiful return from Aruna, taking the ball very early. Staying aggressive, Aruna, African champion from Nigeria.
Left. 7-8.
again pushing his opponent so far away from the table, Xu Xin. Simply beautiful. The powerful forehand from Xu Xin. Side spin there. Creating all these angles. Launching the topspin too strong, giving Aruna 2 game points. Some Chinese audience would like to see Xu Xin win, of course. They're yelling and rooting for him. Let's see if Mr. Xu could bounce back. Well, that is just too good from Xu Xin. Top spin there, full of heavy spin, deep down in the middle, pushing it right to the baseline. Timeout court, that's pretty early for Aruna. He wants to be on board. Xu Xin taking the ball very early. Now even in the score. That's his forehand flick right there, pushing the ball very deep. Wow. Aruna just cannot finish with his second shot, giving Xu Xin 1 game point for a change. Xu Xin deceiving service. Makes him take the first game.
Lock one.
All right, welcome back. Well, hopefully Aruna won't be too dejected, especially after losing the first and opening game. Before that, he was really leading quite a bit. 10-8, getting 2 game points under his belt, but he couldn't capitalize, cash on the points there, even after a timeout that he called. Pretty early to do so.
1-3.
That's Xu Xin. Took the first game, 12-10. Let's see how Aruna fares here. Xu Xin pushing his opponent far away from the table again. Taking advantage of the middle part, pushing it through very deep, gaining 1 more point. A very confident Xu Xin there. Both players looking more settled now.
Five,
Shishun really has a lot of fans here, given that he's very interactive, and he loves this kind of interaction with his audience and fans. Now, last year we were here, he was talking to a lot of them through our interviews, actually through interactive programs and so forth. He says, without audience, without his fans, he probably wouldn't shine that much. He probably wouldn't really be himself. He wants to be part of them, be part of their crowd. So he's a very, very much he's a people person, the people player. And he won this title here, meaning the year-ending ITTF finals in the year of 2012 in Hangzhou, and also in the year of 2013 in Dubai. And men's singles, of course. So that's why he knows that how much it takes to get to the final and how much it takes to really laughs last.
Seven, eight.
A very closely contested game, like the first one. Wow, this one is really very good stuff from Shishun, pushing the ball very deep again. Returning very fast, doesn't really give Aruna a lot of time to think over or to react well. High toss serve, giving himself a 3-point lead and also 3 game points. Sending the ball a bit too long. Aruna saving 1 game point. Well, that is just too good from Shishun. Away from the table, launching his top. Shishun, definitely one of the hot contenders for the Tokyo Games, especially in the mixed doubles. And that actually will be a new event for the Olympics table tennis. And because in the past we never had a Olympic table tennis mixed doubles event. So can Shishun team up with Liu Shiwen as expected to be in the final, to be really the champions of Olympics? This is quite a question there. A lot of people would like to see the answer, because both players are over 30 now. Liu Shiwen, the former champion of this event, is not even here for this tournament, given her injuries. Beautiful stuff from Shishun, again turning around her body to use her topspin, frustrating her opponent quite a bit. Oh, that's really good stuff from Aruna, launching her forehand. Quite a drive. Look at that, so ready for that smash. Creating that beautiful angle, leaving Shishun with no answer. Haruna has really cut down his mistakes, forced and unforced errors, or it's difficult for him to stay in contention. Shishin is more and more settled into his rhythm. Look at that, talking about his rhythm there. With his pen-holding style, he could still create this gun topspin with his backhand on the reverse side. Not to mention this forehand topspin. If he stays quite close to the table to launch this kind of lethal weapon, and you know that you're in trouble. Short serve, lucky one though. Wow, third ball attack style, typically executed. Stay very close to the table, leaning forward to get that done.
3-9.
Commanding lead, really frustrates Haruna. Using this Tao moment to think through. Oh, that is even better from Haruna this time with his forehand topspin. Again, using his body, a pivotal shot right there, generating tremendous power. Go for that kill. Shishin's speed really has made a difference here now, giving himself a 4-point lead and also 4 game points. There you go. Shishin gets it, 11-6. Game four now. Lucky ball in the Haruna's favor. A good beginning for Haruna is very important to survive here. Short return, no, not with this long one. He's been pushed. Shishin cleverly sending the ball very long, close to Haruna's body. Now Haruna's rhythm has been sort of bothered and broken. He needs to really stay in his own rhythm. Otherwise he has no chance. Mm-mm. Rushing the point. That's the last thing you want to do right now. Typical for him to really be focused now. Of course, he is also trailing by 3 games down. 5. Consistency is really what Haruna needs to work on. Launching it parallel beautifully, landing also well, but he needs to finish it well also to be consistent, cutting down his mistakes as well. Right now, Xu Xin is just too strong. He's on his way to punching a ticket for the men's singles quarterfinals.
3-8.
Aruna still needs to stay aggressive. Don't give up. And the winner of this match will meet, as I mentioned, the winner between Lin Yunju of Chinese Taipei and Dmitry Ocharov of Germany.
9-4.
And that match is going to take place tomorrow. Then tomorrow evening we'll have the men's singles quarterfinals to be unfolded.
Five ten.
Xu Xin has got 5 match points here with ease.
11-5.
A beautiful back and flick, sending the ball really deep to Aruna's forehand. Now Xu Xin has taken this game.